Y'all do know I'm like queer as fuck, right? Sure, it's kinda cute, no shade though. I'm just being transparent. First of all, welcome back to another episode of Robbie Rants Season 3. If you've been here before, welcome back. If this is your first time joining, welcome. Today, I want to talk about queer safety and just safety in general in the world is super important. Now, mind you, I don't dress up like this all the time. But even if I did though, what is it anyone's business? I feel like we get caught up in the world with people and how they look. It's been bothering me for a little bit, and as you guys know, mental health is super, super important to me. It makes me feel uncomfortable, it makes me feel anxious, it makes me feel uneasy, and I know I'm not the only one. Representation and how we show up is super important, but why must we be constantly judged for how we look, what we're wearing? And the truth is, at this point, it's not even down to being judged. We're being killed. We're being cursed at. We're being looked at. We're being verbally attacked. Do you know what that does to someone's mental health? Do you know what that does to someone's confidence? It's not all about what the person's wearing, but more so their heart. And in another sense, mind your motherfucking business. Like, can we do more of minding our business? We are dealing with so much in our own world, in our own sense, that we project that negativity onto someone else because someone else is happy, because someone else is comfortable, because someone else is queer, because someone else is confident, because someone else is living their life. It has been breaking my heart that so many people have lost their lives and are afraid. The truth, myself included, and we'll touch on that, have lost their lives and are fearful of being themselves, fearful of walking outside, fearful of just being. You see, every day is a struggle for us. Every day is a struggle to exist, to breathe, to live. And it shouldn't be like that. You should be able to wear whatever you want, whenever you want, because the truth is, it gives us character. It tells us how we're feeling. You can really tell how a person's feeling by what they're wearing. It sends a message. Sometimes, even in my closet, I'm like, oh, I'm not wearing that today. And it's so sad. It's not to a point in my life now. It's like, yes, it is a little bit of fear, but it's more so discernment. It's also knowing where to put my energy and knowing where to be, where I can be in queer safe spaces. And the truth is, we need more of those. We need more queer safe spaces. We shouldn't even have to have queer safe spaces. We should be able to just, again, exist. My question is, if the shoe was on the other foot, if it was reversed, if there were people, if there were queers who were so angry and so hateful of what someone was wearing and wanted to harm them, and you had to fight for your life and fight to exist, or your loved one was taken away, or because someone wanted to transition, you wanted to kill them, how would you feel? How would you feel? How would you feel? You see, it's just utterly disgusting. It makes me sad. It truly makes me sad. Because again, it's not like we're out here trying to harm people. We're just trying to live, man. And every time I feel like, don't get me wrong, we've come further. We've come further from when I was growing up, okay? But it's still hard out here. It's still hard out here. Like, I have got looked at so many looks, okay, let's hit this with so many looks because of my nail, because of the way I dress, or because of the way I look, or because of just the aesthetic, or it's just like, why? it comes to the point where it just has you fed up, and it just becomes, it's just like fight or flight. It just has you fed up because it's like you want to stand up for yourself. You want to be the representation. You want to break the barrier. But breaking the barrier might mean you have to lose your life. And that's not okay. I was truly on the train praying one day, having a conversation with God. And I really was like, you know, some of the messages you spread and some of the things that you talk about and some of the things that you want to talk about and the advocating you want to do, literally, like, and as I say it now, I feel it, like, in a virtual, like, you can be crucified, hypothetically speaking. Everyone's not going to like what I have to say, how I'm saying it, what I'm doing, but the point is, it's the truth. Not everyone can handle it, not everyone can deal with it, but the point is, is the balance. What do we do? Where's the safe space? In my journey with this channel, my hopes is that to really create more safe spaces and to save lives, because I know what it feels like to have anxiety walking down the street, or because of childhood trauma, being bullied and not being comfortable in my skin in my younger days and be able to even advocate for myself. I know what that feels like. So I hope that wherever you are watching this, you continue to fight the fight. Can't do this alone. You continue to just be you unapologetically. I still can't do it. Just continue. Oh my God, just continue. I know this might even hit home for some adults. A lot of people, and I've heard it, have said, oh, if my child was gay, or if I, like, no, it's like, that does to children emotionally. Do you know what that does to children? To the way that they view the world, it'll turn down to how they treat people. We are setting the mark. We are setting the tone for the next generation. And I need you guys to know that, to remember that, to take that serious. Being queer is something I did not think for my life. Like, when I grew up, I didn't be like, oh, that's what I wanna be. Okay, chasing the D. I say that to, like, make you guys laugh. I say that to make you laugh, but in all seriousness, this is something that in the end I end up choosing, you know? And it's like, that's my choice. That's something I have to live with. That's something I have to deal with. And that enough comes with its own set of, like, drama and stuff. It's hard out here in the community. So now I gotta deal with that and trying to, like, exist, live, empower. It shouldn't be that way. Make sure you guys comment below, what are your thoughts about queer safety? How can we create better safe spaces? Because we have to do it together. It can't just be this video. It really boils down to, how are you treating people in the day to day? Not even just queer people. How are we treating people? How can we treat people better? Anytime we're going through something life-threatening, physical, just anything, right? Sometimes we're always wanting sympathy. We're always needing empathy. Think of that when you go to treat someone bad, when you go to give a dirty look at someone, when you go to open your mouth to say someone, when you even think to harm someone. What if this was your child? What if this was someone you loved? What if this was someone you cared about? I just wish more people viewed it from that lens. I just wish more people understood the value of life. You never know who is sent to help you, is sent to help you grow, is sent to be an aid in your healing. Sure, it's kind of cute, no shade though. I'm just, is it not? And even, like, even if a non-queer person could wear this, they would eat it up, especially if it got the body out of it. Anybody can wear this. Anybody can wear anything that they want because they can. it just sucks when we're not judged on what makes us good people. We're not judged on, you know, the things that we should, that makes up our essence of who we are. We should be being judged, period. But like, people don't look at these things. People don't take time to empathize with life. It's really a struggle out here. And there are so many, again, lives being taken, lives being lost due to feeling like they're unsafe or they can't exist or they just can't be. And that goes for anybody in the community, in the world, anywhere. If you are someone who is experiencing this in this current moment or has experienced this, please do not give up. Please know that you aren't alone. Please know that I'm fighting too. I am fighting to live and exist comfortably, happily, with joy, unapologetically too. There are some times I can convince myself, or like each day, or like when I change my hair, or like I go through it too. Trust. I go through it too. Know that you have someone to talk to. Know that someone cares about you. Know that someone gets it. And know that you're not alone. Know that we can build community together. Y'all keep up with the kid. Okay. I just want to talk about it. Like, there are days where it's really, really hard for me to show up. To show up unapologetically. You're not alone. Know that you're valued, loved, and appreciated. Share this to someone who may be having a hard time showing up. If you know someone who has a hard time existing, being, and in fear, please share this to them.